Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me on another video. Today, I am so excited. I'm gonna be talking about my Sephora recommendations. Fragrance edition, of course. We got so many scents in front of us to talk about that are available at Sephora. Right now, they're having their sale, their VIB Rouge sale. I will leave all of the dates down below. I'll put them on the screen somewhere so you guys can see, you know, who gets what, because there are three tiers, the VIB, the VIB Rouge, and I believe the Insider. So it's different categories. I think it's 10, 15, and 20%. Hopefully I'm not completely wrong, but again, I will link everything down below with all that information. When it comes to the Sephora sales, I definitely love it because, you know, fragrances, makeup, skincare, all of that can get really expensive. So a good sale is always all the way up my alley, and I definitely plan on picking up some items. So look out for a haul very soon. If you're new, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. My name is Karina Waldron. We do a lot of fragrance content on this channel. Beauty content is sprinkled on, and I just love making content, and we have a beautiful community. So subscribe if you haven't already. All right, let's go ahead and start with Tom Ford. Of course, you know, it's not new. If you've seen my videos, Tom Ford's gonna appear. So I decided to pull up two fragrances from Tom Ford. This is their private blend collection. I have Tobacco Vanille, and I also have Santal Blush, which is one of the newest addition to my collection when it comes to Tom Ford. And I love them both. You know that I talk about Tobacco Vanille very often. It is one of my favorites from Tom Ford. Gets me a lot of compliments, makes me feel good. It's an all year round fragrance for me. I've worn it in the summer and I've worn it in the winter, and it just works. It's a beautiful kind of aromatic vanilla scent with a nice sweet kind of wet tobacco note in there. And I think it's just absolutely beautiful and very like captivating. Oh, that opening. To me, this is not masculine, even though there is quite heavy notes in there like the tobacco. But like I said, it's more of like this sweet wit tobacco leaf that you're gonna get from this one. It's a little powdery also, and it's just gorgeous. It's very long lasting, has this sexy appeal to it. And if you have my type of style when it comes to fragrances, you are absolutely gonna love it. If you're new to the channel, if you want a bit of a unique vanilla, a little bit more classy and elevated, this is the perfect one. I absolutely love it. And then we have here this gorgeous scent over here, which is Santal Blush. I absolutely love the bottle. I got this one recently, a couple of months back, and I have heard that not every place has this clear bottle. They now come with the black bottle. So if you're lucky, you'll get this one, because I think this is beautiful. This is like, to me, kind of like a sandalwoody scent. It's so creamy, and to me it's feminine. It's very classy and elegant, super wearable. This is like what I thought Le Labo Santal 33 was gonna smell like, honestly. I thought this was what I was gonna get from Le Labo. Unfortunately, the Le Labo Santal 33 did not work on my skin at all. Like I can't even comprehend the notes breakdown and then how it smelled on my skin. It really just didn't go with me at all. This one, oh, it's so creamy and airy, feminine, fluffy, yet woody. But the woodiness on this fragrance, it's not heavy or too much. It's like a creamy woody tone. It's a really hard fragrance to describe for me. You don't pick up every single note. Everything is blended so well. Oh, I love this one. Definitely very clean and fresh also. I think this is a perfect everyday scent. Like if you want a signature scent that is non-offensive but still very elevated and quite elegant, this is absolutely stunning. So moving on to Maison Margiela, and this is the replica line. I have three to mention. One of the bottles, I have no idea where it went to, but I am going to talk about it. But here I have, of course, By the Fireplace. This is a must, okay? If you love your smoky, woody scents, especially for the fall and winter, very cozy and comforting, By the Fireplace is a must. A lot of people shy away from it because of that initial opening. It is very, very, very smoky. Very smoky, but let that simmer. I say that every time about this fragrance. Let it simmer, and honey, you will understand. Oh, you will understand the hype. It's so gorgeous. There's a beautiful vanilla tone in this fragrance. It's woody, it's smoky. It's very warm, like very, very warm, super cozy. It is not, powdery, because I find scents that have this powdery nuance very comforting, but there's something about this one, it's not powdery, but that woody tone is very, very inviting. Oh, the dry down is absolutely my favorite. I always describe this as sitting by the fire roasting marshmallows. That is how this smells. The marshmallow, the sweetness of that. I don't know if there's marshmallow in here. I don't think so, but that's what I get. I get like this roasted marshmallow scent to this one. Oh, it's so gorgeous. This is completely unisex, but anyone can wear this. I absolutely love this for fall and winter for sure, especially winter when it's very cold outside. This just works beautifully. Absolutely beautiful. Love this one. I also have Whispers in the Library, and you guys can see, look at this dent. It is humongous. To me, this is, how can I put this? Let me try and get my little paper over here. So Whispers in the Library, I find, is just so approachable. It's very light, and it's one of those scents that is perfect for those of you who don't want a fragrance that is overbearing, that is too loud, but still quite beautiful. And I actually haven't worn this one in a couple of weeks, so let me, oh yeah. Oh, I like this one so much. I don't remember the note breakdown, but to me, this is a clean, fresh yet woody scent. I don't know why I get this like hint of green tone in the background with this fragrance, but it's just so wearable. The opening is a little bit bright. It's a little citrusy for me. But all in all, it's a very clean, fresh, kind of wearable scent with a slight woody dry down, but the woody tone is not heavy. When you hear woody tones, especially for the ladies that love a feminine scent, it might scare you away, but you'll be very surprised. Try fragrances on your skin first, because sometimes notes can be very deceiving. That's why I don't put so much emphasis on every single note, because a fragrance can smell totally different once it's on your skin. So definitely get a tester, try it out, and see how it works out for you. But this is a beautiful, non-offensive scent, perfect for those who work in an office, a teacher, that kind of setting. You will not offend anyone, and it just smells so good. Like, it smells really, really good. It's not super perfumey, you know, it's not floral and citrus. It is a beautiful scent, so try that one out. That is Whispers in the Library. And the last one that I wanted to mention from this brand is Autumn Vibes, which is a recent purchase for me. I believe I have it upstairs in my room. This is my filming space. And that one is definitely autumn leaves, smoky, woody scent. It's not like this one over here by the fireplace, which is more of a smoky vibe with that sweet vanilla tone. Autumn Vibes to me has more of this green tone, this kind of like woody tone, pine coney kind of smell. I really like it. I thought I wasn't going to like it, and I thought it was going to be too masculine, but I actually really enjoyed it on the skin and on my sweaters. When I spray it on a scarf, it smells so cozy and inviting. So definitely try that one out if you are on a hunt for a perfect fall and winter scent. Okay, next up, we're gonna talk about Kaoli, which has been killing it this year, like literally killing it. And I have these two fragrances over here. Of course, vanilla from Kaoli is absolutely spectacular. Everyone should have their hands on it. I'm not even gonna mention too much about it because you guys know that I love that one. And if you want a really rich vanilla scent, quite sweet, definitely check out that Kaoli one. But I know that it's sold out all of the time. That's why I didn't put so much emphasis on this video. But these two over here are definitely must-haves. They're slightly different, but very kind of grown and sophisticated. This is Deja Vu White Flower 57, and this is the epitome of sophistication. This is a grown woman. She has her stuff together. She is elegant. She knows what she wants. Her plans are in line. She's manifesting. Deja Vu White Flower. Oh my God, this just smells like money. It smells rich. Like, I put this on and I feel like a boss lady, okay? I feel like I got my ish together. It is definitely a white floral fragrance, so you gotta love your like kind of like jasmine, tuberose type of fragrance notes. It's clean, fresh, a little spicy also, slightly woody, but a little spicy. And it's just so lavish. This is definitely ultra feminine to me, and it just makes me feel very, very sophisticated. Elegance in a bottle, 100%. It's slightly more mature than other Kaoli fragrances, but I love it. This is special occasion, date night. I don't find this a casual scent whatsoever, but if you got that lifestyle, honey, this will be your signature scent, and that's all I can say. And then the latest launch was Invite Only Amber 23. And I'm completely obsessed with this one, especially for now that the months are getting colder. Definitely recommend this one over here. It is a very sexy, deep scent. It has a lot of cherry in here. There's oud in here, so it's kind of woody. It's absolutely beautiful. It's not sweet, but yet I don't find this masculine. Like, I don't see a guy wearing this, even though I think they're marketing as unisex. But to me, I still think this is quite feminine. It is slightly powdery, and it kind of reminds me of Christian Dior's Fève Délicieuse. If you don't have that scent and you want something slightly close to it, I find this is like kind of there, but this has a like heavier cherry note. I don't think Fève Délicieuse has a cherry note, but to me, this is like a rich vanilla, tonka bean, cherry, woody scent. It's very, very sensual. Oh, it's so good. In the opening, it's more like Fève Délicieuse. Then I slightly get a mix of Tom Ford's Tobacco Vanille mixed in with some Tom Ford Lost Cherry. It's like all three fragrances in one. That's kind of like where my mind goes, but obviously this is way more affordable, and it's just gorgeous. I find the lasting ability is there, the projection is there. Very intoxicating, very sensual, highly, highly recommend. All right, let's go to Juliet Has a Gun. I recently talked about this fragrance because I just got this in my collection maybe like a week ago, and this is Not a Perfume Super Dose. I always say overdose. Not a Perfume Super Dose, and wow. Do not sleep on this beauty of a fragrance. I cannot believe that I don't hear more people talking about it. This is what the bottle looks like. Maybe that's why. It's not very captivating. The bottle to me, it just seems very like, eh, you know what I mean? It doesn't capture the essence of this fragrance to me at all, because this is a beautiful beast of a fragrance. It smells very like niche-like. It smells absolutely divine. Ooh, oh my God. Oh my God. I don't even know how to describe the scent. I just know that it is rich. It's lavish. It's elegant. It's sophisticated. Oh my gosh. Don't sleep on this one. Definitely try this out if you haven't. it's hard to describe. And even when I look up the notes, I think there's like three notes that they mentioned, but oh gosh, this is a beautiful, sophisticated, elegant scent that is just wearable. It is really, really wearable. To me, this is quite strong. It's intoxicating. It will fill a room and will garner attention for sure. We're gonna speed it up just a little bit because my battery's dying. Battery's dying. Okay, from Killian, I only selected one. And to me, this is my favorite Killian fragrance. I have quite a few now. My collection has definitely grown when it comes to Killian, but Rolling in Love is stunning. If you love your almond fragrances that are sweet, feminine, slightly flirty, this is a stunning scent. First of all, this bottle, let me give you guys a bit of a close up. Oh, look at this. Can you look at this? Absolutely gorgeous. I love the bottle. And you guys saw I have quite a bit of a dent on this one. Let me smell it. Oh God, this is gorgeous. I love wearing this one. I will be honest and say that I wish it was a lot more long lasting without me having to overspray, because I do feel like with this one, now that I've been wearing it for quite a bit, it's not as long lasting as I want it to be. But oh, the scent is just gorgeous. It's creamy floral tones with this kind of like almond milk vibe. It's not lactonic at all. Like, it's not super creamy, but it's very smooth, very silky, feminine. It's a fragrance that puts a smile on my face and makes me feel sexy. Oh, it's absolutely gorgeous. If you like your very smooth, sort of silky fragrances, definitely feminine, a little deep, but not super dark. Okay, there's still a little freshness to that from those beautiful floral tones. This is definitely a must have. Absolutely obsessed with this one. Definitely one of my favorite designer houses when it comes to fragrances. I've talked about them a lot, especially their C lineup. I have an entire video, so go check it out. I'm not even gonna mention it in this video, but definitely my favorite is My Way. This is just a beautiful wearable scent. It's floral, it's vanilla. I find in the winter this gets a little more like warmer than in the summertime when I wear it. It's all year round, but they perform quite differently depending on the weather. In the wintertime, it's warmer. That vanillic tone is a lot more prominent to me in the dry down, and it's just a breath of fresh air. Like, this is a fragrance. Oh, that atomizer is a little rough, I'll be honest with you guys. But it's a fragrance that really just makes you smile. It's very girly to me also, but not juvenile at all. It's white floral, but it is such a modern white floral tone, not vintage whatsoever. It's light, it's approachable, and very crowd pleasing. Like, you will like this scent. Anyone around you that smells it will like it. It is not offensive, not overly complicated. And sometimes that's just what I want. I want a fragrance that just smells beautiful. And this is definitely one of them. And I find Armani does really great scents that have that like essence to them, that are just beautiful, feminine, fresh, airy, like gorgeous scents that just make you smile. This is it right here. About YSL Libre Intense. This is definitely one of my favorite YSL fragrances. When it was released, it was definitely very, very hyped up, especially the original, but my favorite is the Flanker because of that vanilla tone. Oh, this is so beautiful. Oh my goodness. You can't sleep on this one at all. If you haven't put your nose on this fragrance, it's just stunning. And I like that YSL sometimes really steps out of the box and gives you something that is not generic, a little bit different. The original one is a lot more unique. I find it's just a burst of a fragrance. And this one is just a little bit more of that vanilla tone, that deepness, that warmth that you want for the colder months. Long lasting, smells gorgeous, vanilla's in there. There's jasmine in here also. So you will get those beautiful kind of white floral tones. I don't believe that there is lavender in the flanker. Well, I don't pick it up that much, to be quite honest. I really don't pick it up. You will get the DNA of the original one, but this has a little bit more warmth. It's sweeter and it's just absolutely gorgeous. Like, absolutely gorgeous. I understand the hype. Would absolutely recommend that one. And I'm going to also mention Terry Mugler, or as he calls himself now, Mugler, because they have been sold to the L'Oreal brand. They're under their umbrella since about 2 years ago, I want to say. And I absolutely love this scent. Like, that chocolate tone in here is everything to me. This is an intoxicating scent. You don't need too much of it. Ah, so good. It's sweet, rich, warm, spicy. Oh my God, it's so beautiful. It brings me so much memories when I worked in retail, because this was definitely my go-to scent for the fall and winter when I was working in retail. And it just reminds me of that time in my life where I really, really enjoyed all of my clients teaching makeup, and it was so much fun. Well, not that I love retail, but you know, meeting people was fun. But this smells just chocolatey. There's patchouli in here. You will pick it up, but I find the patchouli really goes well with the chocolate nuance of this fragrance. I think it's cacao that's in here. I might be wrong, or maybe hazelnut, but it is this beautiful kind of nutty, chocolatey vibe with that patchouli tone in there that kind of gives it a bit of an earthy tone. Oh, love this one. Love, love, love this one. If you want a gourmand scent that is very long lasting and is a little bit more attainable than like a niche fragrance, this is a gorgeous one. Absolutely love it. And that is it for this list, guys. Those are all the fragrances that I will be recommending for the Sephora sale. So everything will be linked down below in the description box. Thank you so much for those of you who shop through my links. I do make a small commission. I'm very transparent about that. It's always written in the description box. So huge thank you for supporting this channel. Thank you for all the love. And definitely let me know, what are you picking up? Okay, what are you picking up? I already have my cart ready. So I will be getting a little bit of skincare, maybe makeup, I don't know. I'm a very, very, very prone to using the same makeup because I just love the way that it looks and I never try new things. And I don't know if I'm getting any fragrances because my collection is out of control and I need to declutter, girl, for the new year, which is right around the corner. Anyways, guys, thank you for watching. Please leave a comment down below. Give this video a thumbs up as it helps my channel so much. And subscribe if you made it to the end of this video. And I will see you all on the next one. Ciao!